morning, everybody. Hey, today what we're going to be doing is I'm going to be showing some treatments, some at-home treatments. I know that a lot of people are still trapped at home. Hopefully some of you are able to get out a little bit. Our office is open, but I know that a lot of our patients still haven't been 100% comfortable in coming out. We hope that you can. We're taking all the precautions that we can so that you can come in and get treated. However, in the meantime, we are still doing our at-home treatments that I'm showing with the Lived 121 vibrating foam roller. This is one of them without the case, and then I'm going to show you the one with the case today. I've had a request. We are showing today treatments for thoracic outlet syndrome. Now, what thoracic outlet syndrome is, it's tightness that usually occurs from trauma. We see it many times if you've been in a car crash, car accident, associated with whiplash, oftentimes where the seatbelt is holding you down, but that's not the only one. We see it with athletic injuries. We see it with pregnancy for some reason. I think just the swelling and inflammation that comes. But basically, there's tightness that comes into the upper neck, down these muscles right here that are called the scalenes. Oftentimes, this first rib. So if you put what I was used to call checking your oil, I had a scout leader that would push in there, and it's kind of a tender spot anyway. But the thoracic outlet is everything in kind of this area right here, and it pinches the nerves and also constricts blood flow. So oftentimes what you'll end up with is numbness and tingling down into the hand. It will oftentimes be associated with stuff up into the arm. Now, one thing you can differentiate, if it's coming from the neck and there's like a pinched nerve from a disc, it will usually, not always, but usually follow what's called a dermatome. So it will be just in maybe one finger or this part of the hand, or it will be just in parts of the hand, but it won't be the whole thing. If it's just the hand, sometimes we have to be careful of carpal tunnel. So thoracic outlet syndrome can sometimes mimic other things, but it's usually associated with tightness up into this area. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you some really awesome treatments that you can do using the Lived 121 vibrating foam roller. Okay. Okay, now what I'm not going to do is turn it on for this whole time. Otherwise, my voice will be shaking. But the other thing you need to be careful with thoracic outlet syndrome is that when you turn it on, I would be very cautious. We're dealing with nerves here, okay? Now, the vibration really helps the nerves, but if you turn it up, so there's four settings on here. If you turn it up, one, two, three, four, that's a lot of heavy vibration. Now, the last one I'll show, see how that vibrates my voice? So that's why I'm not gonna have it turned on. The last one I will show is with the pectoral stretch, the pec muscle. That one you'll probably wanna turn it up higher. But when you're right up against the neck, I would be very, really careful with how high you're turning it up. Now, what I would do is make sure that the control button is on the front. You're gonna take this and bring it along your back and hold on to it with this opposite hand, okay? So I'm hanging on to it right here. And then you're going to control the front part with this other strap. So again, I would turn it on to probably the lowest setting, maybe a one. The first one that you're gonna do is a neck tip. Now I would focus right on the hinge point, right up against the neck. And again, be careful how much pressure depending on how much irritation of the nerve. If it feels more muscular, you can turn it up a little bit higher so that you can get that stretch. But essentially what we're gonna do is we are gonna do kind of some nerve flossing, but also just some stretch. So you're gonna tip away and you're basically gonna be going back and forth while holding the vibrating foam roller right up against that shoulder crease, okay? And what you're gonna do is you're gonna go about 10 times. So one, two, and you're gonna just tip and make sure that you're not pulling too hard, so hard that it causes a lot of discomfort, numbness, and tingling, especially again, if you're getting more of the numbness and tingling, I would be cautious there. Just make sure you're stretching it nice and easy. We're gonna go 10 times there, okay? Then what we're gonna do, you're gonna take it, I would turn it up pretty high, you're gonna drop it right down the middle. So basically, I've got it right over my head and in a chair, so if you wanna do it lightly, and just have it in a chair. You can do it here if the chair comes up high enough, or you can lay down. Just make sure, again, you're not putting too much pressure. And with this one, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna arch back and you're gonna stretch. But with that vibration going, it's really going to help to open up the thoracic cavity. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go 10 extensions here. So extensions 1, 2, 3, and you're gonna repeat that 10 times, okay? And then depending again on how bad it is, this pec stretch, so you basically, it's because we're trapped in flexion a lot too. We're always kind of facing forward. So it could be from trauma, it could be from just repetitive motion that you'll get thoracic outlet syndrome. But you're gonna roll from this inner pec right here and you're gonna roll it out. Now again, if it's really sensitive, I would just do it with your hand. So press here and roll it out. This one right here, I prefer to get down on the ground. Now I'm not gonna do it because with the video, right? But you're gonna get down on the ground and you're just gonna roll with your arm out until you're gonna kind of hold your body and roll out until it hits this shoulder, okay? And you're gonna do that 10 rolls. So 10 rolls here, okay, all the way out. Or you can just push on it and go all the way out. Now, once we've done each of those, so again, I'm gonna show you drop the strap right down. This one you're probably gonna wanna go a little lighter and we're gonna tip. So 10 tips away and kind of towards, so you can tip towards a little bit as well. Just be cautious there and you're gonna hold it. You may even wanna bring it more forward and you'll be able to tell whether it's more into the first rib, whether it's more into the scalene. So if you're feeling kind of, it should feel comfortable and good, but tip away and traction those nerves for that thoracic outlet to loosen up. Okay, then again, we're gonna go into extension, drop it back, and then you'll repeat that 2 to 3 sets of 10. So we're going into extensions again. This one you can do again, laying down. If you lay down, there is one thing I would say, I prefer having the roller facing this way if you're laying, because that's a lot of pressure to put on the spine. So if I'm laying on the ground, I will put it here and still go into extension, and with that vibration, it's gonna feel really good. But with it being a little bit of a smaller roller with the vibration, I usually place it that other direction, okay? So pulling, flossing back and forth, going into extensions, and then rolling out the pec. 2 to 3 sets of 10 of each of those. And then again, make sure that it's not irritating the nerve. So have it on a lower setting. Unless it feels good, you can turn it up. All right, if you have any questions or comments in that, or if you have any requests, if there's any conditions, please let me know. If you're interested in getting a Live to 121 vibrating foam roller, it's the only one that I'm aware of that has the case, the handles, okay? And that's one of our best things. Both foam rollers on our website. So if you go to livetowhat121.com, there's a black one and a green one. This is the black one. The black one's got these beads. It's pretty, it's a little more aggressive, the black one. The green wave is a little less aggressive. But if you're going to be working those muscles, I'd probably lean more towards the, if you like a deep dig, do the black dot. That one will dig a little deeper. If you're a little more sensitive, I'd go with the green wave. It also comes with a charger, so it will recharge. You don't have to get batteries or anything, so it will really, it recharges. And then, and so get on there and order either one of those, and we'll get that shipped out to you. Right now, until, so depending on when you're watching this, this is 2020, and in April 2020, we are doing the COVID-19, so the COVID-19 discount, 19% off. So that will be, if you type in safe at home, all one word, you'll get 19% off of the foam rollers until the end of April. So that's coming up here. All right, again, if you have any questions, concerns, comments, please let me know. Other than that, have a wonderful Wednesday or whatever day you're watching this.